going to be quite the scene.
And a good Monday afternoon. And a good Monday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Metro Atlantic Athletic Conference Basketball on this afternoon. We bring you inside the legendary Taps Gallagher Center for the Siena Saints, 2-13 overall, 1-3 in conference play, taking on the host, Purple Eagles of Niagara University. Niagara 7-8 overall, and the Purple Eagles come into action today with a conference record of 3 wins and 2 defeats. Good afternoon. My name is Todd Kellen, joined once again by Frank Gallo. And Frank, for the Siena Saints, as we enter play today, they're looking to split the West New York weekend. On the other side, for the Purple Eagles, winners of 4 in a row, including a 96-72 win on Friday against Fairfield.
Yeah, they used a hot start to get out ahead, and they never relinquished it. They didn't let Fairfield get close, and they were able to cruise to victory, ending an 8-game winning streak for the Stags.
And what did it mean in the standings? We'll take a look. The Purple Eagles have vaulted to third place, tied for third with that conference record of 3-2. Siena 1-3. They're near the bottom, but they've been getting some players back, and we'll talk about one of those players as we get to our spotlight players to watch in this afternoon's game. But we'll start with the Purple Eagles, and we will focus on number 11, Ahmad Henderson.
Yeah, Henderson has been very good as of late, especially in that win against Fairfield. Coach Paul has credited his decision-making for getting the offense running. He's averaging over 13 points a game for this group. He has numerous steals on the year, and he's averaging over 30 minutes per contest within the conference.
Big 17 points in the first half to set the tone on Friday night. As we shift our focus now to the Siena Saints, number one, Sean Duroot Gordon.
An immediate impact to the lineup once Duroot Gordon was inserted. He's played in 5 games, and he's already averaging nearly 24 points a game. He's one of their best rebounders as well. Duroot Gordon can do it all, and he's brought life and spirit to this Saint lineup.
There you get a look at Siena Saints head coach Carm Massarello, his fifth season in Albany, 66-57, the overall record for Coach Carm. Frank and I had an opportunity to spend about 15 minutes or so on the phone yesterday with Coach. Got some good info. Felt that the second half in that game on Friday night at Canisius, one of the best 20-minute stretches of the season for the Purple Eagles. There you see their head man, Greg Paulus, in his fifth season here on Montego Ridge. 58-70 is the record. And, well, GP, he loved the start to last game. Niagara started out a house ablaze, 13 of 15 from the floor to open up the ball game. While that was impressive to coach, he was more proud of the fact that they never let Fairfield get it to within single digits. Every time that the Stags made a run, the Purple Eagles had an answer.
It was certainly one of their best complete 40-minute efforts that Niagara's put together so far this season, and willing to duplicate that here against Siena this afternoon.
Harlan Obioha in the center jump circle. He wins the tap, and we are underway. Well, I wish you a happy Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Here is the Purple Eagles. The game pushed back 24 hours due to that massive winter storm in Western New York. Up here, though, on campus, boy, not much snow to talk about at all. What a difference. Randy Tucker, left corner three. That one no good. Rebound out to Mason Courtney. He has it. Good look there for Tucker.
Elite jersey matchup here today, too, with the golden purples for Niagara.
Entry pass. This is Gribben. Finds Emma Juru. One dribble over Obioha, but good defense there without fouling for Harlan. Back come the Purple Eagles. Bumbleo, now they feed it into the post. Here's Yao, size mismatch against Duroot Gordon. Little fadeaway jumper, that one dances across the rim. Weak side rebound, again, this time Courtney with the carom.
That's going to be a big matchup throughout the afternoon with Obeng Mensa and Duroot Gordon matched up.
Michael Ely with it now. Mac Rookie of the Year a season ago. Entry pass knocked away, out of bounds it goes. It'll go over to the Purple Eagles.
Good ball pressure because Obeng Mensa got picked on the backside, so it was open, the play that was designed, but Niagara's pressure on the ball caused a turnover, and they were all over the court defensively on Friday, causing turnovers against Fairfield. See if they could do that again here today.
You knew it would be tough for the Purple Eagles to replicate that hot start like they had on Friday night. Here's Ahmad Henderson, fakes the three, jump stop of the paint, no, feeds it to Harlan off the window, no good. Harlan missed it from in tight, certainly thought he was fouled. Coach Paulus also working on Jason Bradwell as he cuts in front of him. And the Majuru, the shot off the back of the iron, no good, and the rebound to Obioha.
And that last dish by Henderson is what had Niagara clicking offensively. His decision making when cutting that time got Obioha, couldn't get the finish though.
Here is Harlan with the top of the key. Backdoor cut, Bumbolo now in the corner. Yeah, up top, Tucker wide open, three, and that is good. And Randy Tucker has the Purple Eagles in flight.
And that's that ball movement that Coach Paulus was so happy with. There's no one really held on to that ball for more than a second, led to the open three.
Siena starters brought to you by UBMD. Gribben, Amajuru, Juru Gordon, Ely, and Courtney. Here is Ely with the basketball now. One dribble looking into the post. Good denial defense there by Harlan. So they go to Juru Gordon along the baseline. A whistle and an offensive foul. Yao Obang Mensa was there to the spot first, and Juru Gordon barreled into him.
Yeah, you can see him initiate the contact. As we'll take another look at that three that was for Tucker's. Niagara was able to move it around, resulting in the opening basket, but a great job by Obang Mensa in the feet set and taking that charge keeps Yen off the board.
That is the first foul of the ball game. Take a look at the Purple Eagles starters. First the shot, that one no good. Weak side rebound, Niagara starting. Tucker, Bumbolo, Henderson, Obang Mensa, and Obioha. Juru Gordon, left elbow jumper, that one no good. Offensive rebound, and the putback is good by Killian Gribben. Offensive rebound, Frank, that's a phrase we may say a lot today for Siena.
Siena, one of the best teams in the country at getting to the offensive boards. Over 36% of their misses, they're bringing in to get second opportunities.
Here's Yao with it. Extra dribble, going to go all the way to the bucket off the window. Good, it settles through. Yao wanted to go to the pass in the corner, but good defense by Siena. So Yao making a decision to stay with it and somehow able to coax that one through. Here's Courtney off a good screen by Amajuru. Now Ely has it, looks to his left. Courtney there. Back to Michael Ely. Purple Eagles defenders are there on the catch. Juru Gordon with it, little hesitation move, knocked out of bounds, last touch by Juru Gordon, and Harlan Obioha providing good help.
Yeah, you can see how Niagara was attacking that. The double team went where Obang Mensa stayed behind, and it was Obioha who came over and caused the turnover. The double team was ready to rotate.
Feed it into the post, Obioha with the catch, but a foul from behind. It will be on Giovanni Amajuru. They call him Gio, we may as well. A lot of syllables there, but Giovanni. Niagara trying to get Harlan involved at both ends of the floor. He's done good work on the glass and also defensively. Entry pass, he keeps it himself. 20 to shoot as Ahmad Henderson with the catch. Peeks over his left shoulder. New play call barked out by fifth-year head coach Greg Paulus. Here's Ahmad, pull up two. That is good.
That's what he can do. He can create space for himself. We saw him dish that earlier down low. That time the pull-up jumper, good for a pair.
Over 4 minutes in, just one bucket for the Saints. Amajuru has it. Obioha drops back. Now they go Juru Gordon, left wing, feed it into the post. Amajuru with the catch. Spins to the right, shot away, partially deflected by Obioha. Harlan meeting the challenge defensively in the post.
And that's where he's gotten better, by not taking that foul.
Three is good by Henderson. And a timeout called by Siena. The Saints defense really dropped back. And Ahmad said, I will take my chances at this. Timeout. We will step aside as well. Here is that look from Ahmad on the money again for the freshman. Folks, we're going to step aside. More to come when we come back. Purple Eagles out early. They've scored 10 of the game's first 12 points right here on ESPN+. Thank you. I don't know if you can hear me, but can you give me like a countdown to when I should get out? I just kept laughing there waiting for the countdown, so sorry. All right, thank you. You're like, when is Todd going to shut up? What are we coming back with? Thank you. Who's first? And we welcome you back inside the Gallagher Center. The timeout called by Coach Massarella, trying to put the brakes on a 10-2 run by Niagara. Let's take a look at our keys to the game. They are sponsored by Howard Hanna agent Ryan McNabb. You'll find him on Center Street in Lewiston. Coach Carm said two big things they want to do today: guard the three, and also good to great on shot selection. That is being unselfish. If you've got a decent shot, but a teammate has a better one, give up the basketball.
Yeah, 0-for-2 so far in that category, but we're still in the early goings.
On the other side for the Purple Eagles, limit Siena to one shot. Frank told you about how skilled Siena is at getting that offensive rebound, so have it be one and done, and continue to share the basketball. The Purple Eagles, 5 double-digit scorers in victory on Friday night. That is ideal. Michael Lely with the basketball and a reach-in foul on the Purple Eagles, number 5, Luke Bumbalo. For Luke, that is his first, team's first. Same starting five out on the floor for both sides. So Siena, they have lost 8 in a row. 1-3 in conference play. Michael Lely, baseline jumper is good.
Yeah, good motion that time. Able to spring Lely, and he hits that mid-range jumper. That's where he can be effective out on the court for the Saints group.
Entry pass down low. Obioha, ball fake, went up and missed. He was on the lay-in from right in front. That's a good job by Amajuru, who was fooled by first the fake, but he elevated right away. Consecutive times, that impacted the shot. Courtney, free throw line jumper is good. Mason Courtney back in the starting lineup, his second consecutive start. And just like that, out of the timeout, 4 straight by the Saints.
Another good screen, opened up that shot. See if they continue to try to expose the mid-range jumper area.
Obioha with it. Back to Bumbalo. 13 to shoot. Luke goes to his right, a 3 on the way. Good! A little wiggle from left to right, and Luke Bumbalo knocks down the 3rd 3-pointer for the Purple Eagles in the early going.
Yeah, he's great from behind the arc, shooting nearly 43% of the season. That's his 15th just in conference play.
As far as team shooting goes, no team better than the Purple Eagles from three-point range. Ely, a deep 2 on the way, and that is good. And the team's now heating up after a cool start.
That was a tough shot to make, too. But Ely in a rhythm right now off those 2 jumpers and able to sink it.
These teams met 3 times a season ago, including in the MAC tournament where the Purple Eagles defeated Siena. In the quarterfinal, Michael Ely poured in 16 points though in Atlantic City. Pass up top, Ahmad. He's got a 3 on the way. That's deep, no good. Rebound battled for, and it'll roll to Michael Ely. Back come the Saints, down by 5. 3 consecutive scoring trips for Siena, and Ely overshoots that one. Rebound battled for Amajuru and Obioha, and the extra lift from Obioha. Tapped it to Bumbalo. Now Tucker, 3, rattles out, no good. Obioha with the rebound. In the paint, had it knocked away, and Gribben steals it away for the Saints.
Yeah, quick hand that time.
Here's Duru Gordon stepping through the paint. Runner, no, taps in his own rebound. First bucket of the day for Sean Duru Gordon.
And this is the pace that Niagara you would expect to be thriving at. Siena's turned up the pace, and they've been able to close the gap in a hurry.
8-3 run by the Saints since that timeout. Bayless, Quan Marble Jr., and Dre Bullock at the scorer's table for Niagara. They'll check in at the next whistle. Joined by Emi Rutai-Sire. 6 to shoot. Here's Yao with it. Going to work on Gribben. Spins in the paint. Ball fake. Fadeaway jumper. No good. And the rebound to Duru Gordon. Well, the Saints bench coming alive there. They like that defensive set for Siena. They really made Niagara struggle for that look. Courtney, ooh, nearly a steal by Henderson. Mason Courtney on the bounce, pulls up his jumper on the way, no good. Rebound battled for Emmett Juer, has it stolen away by Henderson. Here comes Ahmad into the front court. He is bodied into by Mason Courtney, and that'll be a foul on the sophomore. That is his first.
And there we saw Amajuru get the offensive rebound, but the Purple Eagles had three players surrounding him. Allowed Henderson to sneak in, get the steal. That still counts as one and done. As Niagara's doing a good job limiting those second opportunities so far.
So Quan Marble the second, Emi Rutai Sire, Braxton Bayless, and Dre Bullock join Ahmad Henderson. Ahmad the only holdover from the starting five for the Saints. Zach Tekken has checked in, as has Michael Evbagaru. Here's Dre Bullock with it. Now to Bayless. Bayless to Ahmad off a screen. Triple on the way. Off the iron. No good. Offensive rebound, Emi. Up top to Dre. Fakes a three. To the bucket. Off the window. It rolls out. Emi battling for the rebound. Stolen by Duru Gordon. And back he comes. Stepping through the paint. Floater is good. And it's a one-point game.
Duru Gordon thrives in traffic. Able to split defenders that time and lay it in. And the Saints, as Todd mentioned, within one.
Here's Dre, left side now to Quan. He finds Bayless. Immediate timeout at the next whistle. Here's Braxton looking for some help. Picks up his dribble now to Dre. He peeks at the shot clock, sees 10 on it. Goes left wing, Quan. Quan cut off there, good defense. Now Dre, four to shoot, all the way to the bucket. Too strong. Niagara again missing in tight. Rebound to the Saints. Evbagaru now to Duru Gordon. Cut off there by Bayless. The pass up top, Tekken. Whip it around the perimeter. Michael Ealy has it. Pick and roll. Driven to the bucket. Layup no good. Too strong. Rebound tapped up. That missed. And Bayless pulls it away for the Purple Eagles. Entry pass down low. Emi with the catch. Ball fake underneath. Layup no good. He missed it. Goes up again with the right hand this time. And he's able to finish.
And it's the Niagara offensive rebounding that's been doing really well, as they have three of them. But that was one of the first times they're able to convert. Up their lead back to three.
Emi switched to the right hand in tight quarters. Here's Zach Tekken with it, coming off the bench for the second consecutive game. That pass intercepted by Ely. The Saints work it left wing. Tekken didn't hoist a three. He'll go into the corner. Gribben stepping into a triple, and that one is good. Killian Gribben from Letterkenny, Ireland. He has five to lead the Saints, and we are tied at 15.
Big push by Siena since that timeout. Now on a 9-2 run over the last 4 minutes of play.
Ahmad being ball hawked there by Tekken. Finds a teammate in Bayless. Bayless jab step right, kicks it in the corner. Kwan's got a wide open three there, and he overshot the rim. Waiting for it on the weak side was Duru Gordon. Here are the Saints, an opportunity for their first lead of the game. Tekken going baseline against Emi, cuts him off. Duru Gordon now on the catch, pulls up, 10-footer, left baseline, good. Duru Gordon has six, and the Saints have their first lead of the afternoon.
Yep, push that now into a 5-0 run. And Siena shooting lights out since they took that timeout.
On the other side, the Purple Eagles are 6-for-19. Bayless off balance, and that one rimmed out.
The Niagara's getting good looks at the rim. Bayless had an open shot that time, just can't find that range from in close.
Three subs ready to check in at the next whistle. Bumbleow for the Purple Eagles and a turnover on the Saints for Tekken. We'll tell you about the Siena subs when we come back, as we have now reached our under 12-minute media timeout. Niagara trailing it by two. Another bucket by Duru Gordon. We'll be back after this. welcome you back. Time now to take a peek at our Tale of the Tape, brought to you by Legends. And Frank, there we see the good shooting by the Purple Eagles. They lead the MAC in both of those categories. Siena has struggled from three-point range, but as long as you've got that graphic up, rebounds per game, you talked about 36% of the Siena misses, they get the offensive rebound. It all adds up to a usual advantage for the Saints on the boards.
Yes, but so far Niagara's been able to limit that. Each team with three offensive rebounds. What's happened for the Purple Eagles, though, is that terrific shooting that we're so used to seeing on them has gone cold. They're one for their last 10 from the floor, one from their last five from beyond the arc. If they can find that touch again, they have the recipe for success.
Purple Eagles started five of their first 10, but with one for the last 10, they are shooting just 30%. On the other side, the Saints, they are at 50%. Two-point advantage for Siena. A whistle and a holding foul on Zach Tekin as Luke Bumbalo, who we've seen come off screen all season long. Luke really working hard along the baseline, and Tekin reached out and grabbed a hold. Fourth team foul on the Saints.
Yeah, and Coach Massarello is looking to get Tekin into the game in different ways because he can do a lot of things for the Saints group. By bringing him off the bench, he's able to find his niche.
Here is Bumbalo with it now. Lob pass down low, caught by Obi Oha, going too strong off the window, trying to draw the foul on Emma Juru, but the whistle never came. Juru Gordon has it now. Knocked away by Bayless. Bayless will go coast to coast and lay it in, and we are tied at 17.
Bayless is the Purple Eagles' leading scorer when in MAC contests, nearly 15 a game, coming off the bench, even though he still plays about 24 minutes. He's been so good for Niagara as their sixth man.
Six different Purple Eagles have scored. Here's Tekin, had a three, didn't hoist. Takes it down low. Runner blocked away by Kwan, but a whistle and a foul. We'll see who this is on. It is on Kwan Marble. For Kwan, that is his first. There you see the pocket pick there by Braxton Bayless. Quick little glance in the rearview mirror, and he knew he was in. So Zach Tekin will go to the line. Tekin just about a little bit better than a 50-50 proposition on the season. The sophomore from Istanbul, Turkey is 56%, 23 for 41. Leads the club with three assists per game. Free throw on the way is good. Looked good there. So last season, Niagara went 2-1 over the Saints, each team winning the regular season game on the opposing team's home floor. Elias checked in, Duru Gordon out. And then in the MAC tournament, Niagara won it by a 71-65 count. Second free throw, in and out, no good. The lead stays at one for the Saints. Kwan now left wing, man-to-man defense by the Saints. Bayless in the corner to Kwan. Fake the three, and a foul is called. Good ball fake there by Kwan, and will draw the foul on Ebagaru. That is the first. Fifth team foul, 20 on the shot clock for Niagara.
And this is the depth that the Purple Eagles have. They've been able to rotate so many players in and out. It'll allow them to have fresh legs come the second half, but that's one thing Coach Paulus definitely uses is the depth on this team to his advantage.
Backdoor cut, Bumbalo able to rise up and get that one off the window. Luke has five, Niagara back in front.
Obi Mensah threaded the needle, then Bumbalo did a great job. There was a lot of traffic, but he was able to box out, avoid the foul, and kiss it off the glass for two.
Bagaru now to Emma Juru. Dribble handoff, Ely. Michael Ely had a good start to this game before he came out. Whip it around the perimeter. Tekin has it. Shot clock now at five. Tekin into the paint. Ball fake goes all around Bayless, and he gets that one to drop through. 3 points in the game in the last three for Zach Tekin. Last three for the Saints as now the Purple Eagles take it across midcourt. Well, we appreciate you spending part of your Monday afternoon with us here in a game that got rescheduled due to the storm over the weekend. Not a lot of snow here. Don't ask Frank, because no. Frank spent a lot of the last 48 hours with the snowblower. Obi Oha, free throw line jumper is good.
An underrated part of Obi Oha's game is his perimeter shooting. He possesses some really good touch for a big man. He can make them from out there.
Tekin, bounce pass goes through the paint. Tekin's got it again. Courtney Now a Beggar along the baseline against Obang Mensa. Shot blocked by Obioha, but a foul is called. The foul will be on Obang Mensa. That's his first. We're going to step aside for the under 8 minute media timeout with the Purple Eagles leading it by the score of 21-20. How did they get there? Courtesy of Harlan Obioha.
Care is built into the culture at Niagara University. I really see it in all the professors here. How are you not going to approach teaching that way when the university, at its core, is about caring and compassion?
What do you expect from that first job out of college? Working your way up from the bottom? Instead, how does this sound? Starting in a guaranteed leadership position with people who look to you for guidance because you're trained to give it and make important decisions in critical situations. Skip entry level. Decide to lead as an Army officer.
Career in professional baseball, football, or hockey, sport brand advertising, or collegiate athletics administration is within your sights with an undergraduate or graduate degree in sport management from Niagara University. Learn more at niagara.edu.
We are more than athletes. We strive to create an environment where student athletes feel comfortable speaking about their mental health struggles.
Suicide is the second leading cause of death for teens and young adults ages 10 to 34.
25.5% of adults ages 18 to 24 are having seriously considered suicide this month.
Let's eliminate the stigma where asking for help is a sign of weakness.
Let's talk about it now so we don't regret it later.
You are not alone. Call 988 if you are experiencing a mental health crisis.
And we welcome you back inside
the
Gallagher Center.
At Niagara University.
Both teams still huddled around their coaches. Niagara leading it 21-20. Let's take a look at the series history brought to you by Blue Ox Roofing, the premier roofing company in the greater Niagara region. All time, Siena, there you see, they have the upper hand as this is meeting 111. They have sawed off the last 10. And there is that, from the third panel, the Mac Turney win. A late three-point bucket by the Purple Eagles put that game away. That was a nip and tuck battle throughout the second half, but Niagara would hang on to win it 71-65 to advance to the semifinals of last year's MAC championships. They will once again be held inside Jim Whalen Boardwalk Hall in Atlantic City. Free throw on the way, no good by Bagaru, and he is less than 50%. 48% when he walked through the doors this morning. He was 12 for 25, make him 12 for 26, and 13 for 27 as he splits a pair. He will check out. Killian Gribben, who had a good start to this game for the Saints, comes back in. Gribben has 5 points, and we are tied at 21. For the Purple Eagles, Bumbelow in a hurry into the front court. Bullock, Bumbelow, Bayless, Obioha, Obang Mensa. Baseline pass. Bullock, reverse layup, spins through. Great ball fake initially to give just enough room.
And Bullock, at first it looked like he was going to run out of space down low and have to dish it, but he was able to go to the reverse layup and get Niagara back out in front.
Frankie talked about the depth of the Purple Eagles. Niagara now has 8 different players have scored. Duru Gordon with the basketball, now left wing. Purple Eagles switch defenders, so the pass up top to Michael Ealy, a preseason second team All-MAC selection. Duru Gordon back to Ealy, 8 to shoot, ball fake, steps in a 2 on the way, and that one is no good. Dance off the top of the rim, saved by Obang Mensa to his teammate Bayless. Here comes Braxton into the front court, now to Luke. Step up, 3 is good! Slam it on the brakes, rising up and swishing another one through. Bumbelow has 8.
And for the Saints, you have to anticipate that shot coming. He's such a good three-point shooter. You want to guard against it because Niagara's so good from behind the arc, but if Bumbleau's going to get those type of looks, could be a long day.
Juru Gordon gets cut off. Now to Ely. He tries to answer. His three, no good. Rebound, Bullock. Outlet, Bayless. Throw it down the court. Obang Mensah. Lay-in is good, and seven straight by the Purple Eagles, just like that. It's a 28-21 game.
Obang Mensah must have knew exactly where he was on the court as he got his defender the back down and left himself just enough room to lay it in.
Duru Gordon has it. Pulls up, left elbow jumper, settles through. This is quite a score. Sean Duru Gordon has eight. Coach Massarella talked a little bit about how the team beginning to get more and more comfortable with Duru Gordon on the floor. He received the green light. His eligibility as a two-time transfer came through middle of December. And they're, again, beginning to get more and more familiar with Duru Gordon on the floor. Obi Oha with it now, whips it into the corner. Bullock pulls the trigger, a three, and that is good. Dre Bullock steps outside of the arc. He has five, and Niagara's lead back to eight.
Again, good distribution of the basketball. Niagara with nine assists already with their 31 points.
Up top, Ely has it. Ely, free throw line jumper, and that one is good. That was decent defense by Bumbleau, but sometimes you tip your cap to the opponent, and Ely has six.
And to your point about learning to play with Duru Gordon, one, how he handles the basketball, but they're also utilizing him in some different positions. So guys are playing positions that they're not necessarily accustomed to being in, so that's how the Saints are kind of growing with him on the floor.
Bayless misfired, and then he came down awkwardly, and Braxton Bayless, boy, feeling his back, and he went back down. We will take the under 4 minute media timeout. Concern for the Purple Eagles. Get Braxton Bayless on the court. Timeout. Niagara leading it by six right here on ESPN Plus. Well, there you get a look at Braxton Bayless. He was helped up by his teammates and athletic trainer John Monroe. And certainly Braxton not close to 100%. And boy, how important has he been for the Purple Eagles? We'll see how quickly the senior from Ankeny, Iowa can come back, but averaging just about a dozen points per game. He had 13 points in 20 minutes. Frank talked earlier about how productive he has been coming off the bench, as you see Ed Corliss, the lead referee, talking with Purple Eagles head coach Greg Paulus. But there is Braxton again in the background, just hobbling a little bit. But Coach Paulus really said it's a tribute to the young man, Bayless, and how he has not only accepted but thrived in the change from starter last year to the sixth man this season and still playing starter's minutes. Here is Ely with it. Off a screen, a two on the way is good. And Michael Ely really feeling it here. He has eight first-half points.
This jumper's been great. That's his first one from the floor. But to your point about Braxton Bayless, he's finding multiple ways to contribute. He leads the team in steals with 15. He's second on the team in assists. So he's helping all over the floor.
Obi Oha feeds it into the post. Yao going to work. Backing down the defender. Shot in the way. No good. Too strong. It rimmed out. Offensive rebound. Harlan put back. No. Followed up by Yao. This time it drops through. And the Purple Eagles hammering the offensive glass, taking a page out of the Saints playbook.
So now second chance points. Tied at four each. Niagara will take that all day long.
Ahmad Henderson working hard against Courtney. Pass up top. Of Begduru. Now he goes left wing. Duru Gordon. Puts it on deck, spinning on Obang Mensa, hanging in the air and knocking it in. 10 in the first half for Sean Duru Gordon, the redshirt junior from Harlem. He's averaged nearly 24 points in the five games that he has played so far for the Saints. Incredible. Obi Oha, one dribble. Now to Randy Tucker, who's checked in. Bayless was helped into the Purple Eagles locker room, so a little shortened bench here for Niagara. Whip it across the floor. Tucker with the catch. Takes it along the baseline off the window. Good. Randy Tucker now with five.
What a decision made by Tucker as that pass came from all the way across the court. Thought he was going to try to spot up for three, but found the alleyway to get two more. Niagara's lead extended to six.
2:02 left first half. Our Milk for Life halftime report comes your way after the first 20 minutes. Interior pass, Ely, and he lays it in. That time moving without the basketball. And a good pass. That time it was Evbagaru that found Ely in a pass that traveled about a foot. Cleared enough space for Ely to lay it in. Four-point game again. Here's Ahmad. He's going to pull the trigger on a three. That one no good. And the rebound to the Saints. Obi Oha got banged into underneath. Shot at the other end. No good. Rebound Tucker. And we have, I believe, an official timeout. Purple Eagles will make the substitution. That is to allow an injured player, Harlan Obi Oha, to come off the court. And I believe that they may take a look, as we can remind you coming up, our Milk for Life halftime report. We'll take a look at the Voco, the Cadence out-of-town scoreboard. Also first-half stats and first-half highlights. So it appeared as though Harlan may have taken a shot below the belt.
Yeah.
Jason Bradwell comes over. Jason Bradwell lets us know they are going to take a look at the film to see if there was a flagrant foul on the rebound that the Saints got. That Harlan was in the area. He almost immediately doubled over, is overdoing it, but certainly just paused a minute because he got a shot below the belt.
He was feeling the effects, that's for certain. We'll call that the Christian Wilkins move. As we'll take another peek at it as you see the officiating crew doing the same.
So there is the carom. The contact had already happened. And then you see the clear rebound by Ely. Ahmad Henderson missing on the three. So I don't know that there was anything in that look. And across the court, as you see Ed Corliss teaming up right now with Jerry Heater to look at the monitor. They have more angles than we do here, but we have another one, I believe, queued up with Niagara having a 4-point lead. Little different angle here, and boy, just as, of course, the camera following the basketball, you could see that Killian Gribben knocked into Obi Oha. After review, they've indicated that nothing foul there and nothing that needed to be a flagrant foul. There was no foul called initially, and they have certainly backed it up with that review. So 35-31, it'll be Purple Eagle basketball.
Yeah, nothing really there on the video that you could make that call with, but the Purple Eagles leading by four, 90, just under 90 seconds on the clock. But Siena, we showed the graphic, they're the worst field goal percentage team in the MAC, but they are shooting very well today with Duru Gordon and Ely, as the two of them are 10 for 15.
So they have 20 points combined, 20 of the 31. Back pass, Emmy, he can hit that three, couldn't, 10 to shoot. Ahmad Henderson with 65 seconds left in the first half, pull-up jumper, swish! Oh my, Ahmad, he was going to try and take it to the bucket. That path was cut off, so the little six-footer gives him 7 points.
He's so quick, he can make that pass on that drive or go for the jumper. You just never know what he's going to do. That's what makes him so difficult to defend against.
If Bagaru is fouled by Randy Tucker. First on Randy, fifth team foul. Neither team in the bonus yet. Not in the bonus yet. Each team has committed five fouls. So still two fouls away from the one and one. If it's a non-shooting infraction, Dre Mullick checks in. Luke Bumbleow will come out.
Both teams have been playing a fairly clean game. No one in real foul trouble, so the coaches have their entire bench at their disposal.
Entry pass caught by Duru Gordon. Yao out on him, trying to keep him in check along the baseline. Steps through, and that is a traveling violation. Good defense first by Yao, but some help by Dre. Certainly didn't hurt.
Yeah, that Niagara double team has been key today to guarding Duru Gordon, especially down low. The rotation's been very good. That double team arriving just in the nick of time.
See if Niagara hurries here and tries to get a two for one. Ahmad Henderson does, off the window, no good. Rebound to the Saints. That is no doubt what Ahmad was trying to do. Ev Bagaru back to Duru Gordon along the baseline into Emmy. Shot on the way, no, but a foul is called on Emmy Rutai Sire. For Emmy, that is his first, and Duru Gordon will go to the line.
Yeah, Duru Gordon got Rutai Sire in the air. You'll see it right here as he comes over. There's the jump. Contact's going to go as a block every time against the defender. That sends Duru Gordon to the line to shoot two.
If Emmy goes straight up, he's okay. But you can see on that just a little bit of a lean, a little bit into the path of Duru Gordon. So here is the Harlem, New York native, went 8 for 10 from the stripe on Friday night and knocks down his first chance here today. How about this number? After Friday, where he set a career high with 30 points, he is averaging over 20-plus points per game in his first five games as a Saint. He is the first player in Siena's 48-year D1 history to burst onto the scene with that kind of production. Second free throw, good. He is as good as advertised.
Just a natural shooter. You can see the touch he possesses. The Niagara's going to use the timeout here to talk about this last possession.
Coach Paulus using the use it or lose it, aptly named. 25.5 seconds left. This has been a good one. Purple Eagles with an early surge, but well, since that 10-2 lead, it has been a game that the math would tell you Siena has outscored the Purple Eagles by four since then. But this is a very well-played game.
Yeah, Siena's been very consistent throughout the half. They haven't wavered in their shooting or anything like that. Niagara's gone through some massive ups and downs. They started the game very well with their shooting. Then they went cold, 1-for-10 from the floor, 1-for-5 from behind the arc. But then they come out and they start hitting shot after shot after shot. So a bit of a different approach. Siena more calm and consistent. Niagara, some big swings, but it's coming down towards the half, and we have a good one here in the Gallagher Center.
Yeah, we really do, and as the Purple Eagles found out last weekend, you have a good weekend. Niagara swept the road trip at Manhattan, and at Iona, you can vault up the standings. Siena would love nothing more than to have this be the springboard that they need. Visiting with Mike Demos from the Siena sideline prior to the game, he said a couple things. He said, you know, we get the sense we're just that one big win away from using it as that springboard to get back to playing Siena Saints basketball with the kind of record that they and their fans are used to. Certainly nobody had 2-13 coming out of the gate, but overall doesn't matter anymore. It's all conference record, and Siena trying to get to within a game of 500 here. Bumbleow being hawked by Michael Ealy. Bumbleow for the Purple Eagles, keeping that dribble alive. 7 seconds left across the floor. Ahmad Henderson fakes a three, steps down low, layup on the way, good, he's able to finish in traffic, and that will bring it to a close of the opening half.
And again, you just don't know what he's going to do. That time, Siena very aggressive in guarding the three. There's the defender coming out. Well, he's going to use his quickness, get to the rim, doesn't matter who's going to be in his path, he's laying it in for two.
Great finish there by Ahmad Henderson. Still hasn't stuck the landing. Halftime report after this. And we welcome you back inside the Gallagher Center. Time for our halftime report brought to you by Milk for Life. As 20 minutes now in the books, and the Purple Eagles leading it by the score of 39-33. My name is Todd Kellen. Once again, that is Frank Gallo. And Frank, a very entertaining, well-played opening 20 minutes. We'll start with the Purple Eagles. Eight players have scored, good balance, and Ahmad Henderson leading the way at the end.
Yes, when the Purple Eagles are operating with multiple players contributing offensively, that's when they're at their best. Henderson's the catalyst, but when you get Obeng Mensa involved, you get Tucker involved, all of a sudden the defense doesn't know where the ball's going, and Niagara can click.
On the other side, Duru, Gordon, and Ely have been sensational for the Saints, and they can keep it up. They're that good. They are pacing the Saints through the first half.
Two very pure shooters. Now, the Purple Eagles have done a very good job on the defensive rebounds. That was key, but it's left some open shots for Ely and Duru Gordon on the outside, and they're converting.
Last thing for you quickly before we get to our MAC Players of the Week. Niagara has not attempted any free throws in the opening half. This is the best free throw shooting team in the league. Sometimes that means they are settling maybe too much for jumpers. They're shooting, you know, in the mid-40% range, so that's not horrible. But I got to think Coach Paulus in that locker room is saying, get to the free throw line.
Early on this season, Obi Oha had some foul trouble and didn't stay on the floor as much as he was like. Let's see if he can get a little bit more aggressive with his drives, invite some contact, and get a trip to the line.
Well, we certainly will look for that. In the second half, let's take a look now at our MAC Players of the Week, and we'll start with the MAC Rookie of the Week, and that is the Purple Eagles' very own Ahmad Henderson. The second had an average of 12 points per game in that weekend sweep. Last weekend in the New York City area, 10 in the win on the Friday night against Manhattan, follows it up with 14 inside the Heinz Center as the Purple Eagles beat the Gales to sweep that big weekend series. It was their third win in a row. They beat Fairfield on Friday night for their fourth win in a row, and they were able to slow down Bryson Goodine. He is the MAC Player of the Week from Fairfield, the redshirt senior from New Bedford. How about 40 points that he poured in against the same Siena Saints club that was on the road in Albany? The first 40-point non-overtime game in the country this season. 24 of Goodine's 48 occurred in the second half. Well, Siena certainly playing a lot better defensively here. 6-point game. More to come in our halftime report after this on ESPN+. Well, still awaiting both teams' arrival on the court here inside the Gallagher Center for second half action. Niagara leading it by a half dozen there. You see the tally, 39-33, as we just now see the Saints emerge from their locker room. We'll take a look at our first half stats. First half stats brought to you by Toshiba. Toshiba, the official office technology provider of Niagara University. Great shooting by the Saints. They come in averaging 39% overall from the floor, 56% today. They shoot about 25% from three-point range, twice as good here today. The Purple Eagles answering 46% overall and just about 42% rebounding, Frank, and points in the paint. The Purple Eagles 22-18, outscoring Siena down low.
Yeah, and it's been the rebounding head for Niagara. They've only given up 3 offensive rebounds still to the Siena team. So, limiting the chances off those short rebounds and putbacks. But you see, there's also less rebounds for Siena to get because of how well they're shooting the ball. 5 of 7 for Juru Gordon, 5 of 8 for Ely. They've been very good so far.
We saw that on Friday night. Not a lot of offensive rebound chances for the Purple Eagles against the Stags because they shot 73%. Let's take a look at some of the first half highlights. There is Michael Ely. Does not need a lot of room. You can see Bumbleo was in the neighborhood. Then Ribbon up top to Ely. Again, not a lot of room. That's how good Michael Ely has been. 10 first half points. And Duru Gordon, the step through, he's got a dozen.
Yeah, he's been so impressive. He can go to the rim. He can take open jumpers. He's an all-around player for the Siena team.
Gribben hit that corner three, and there is Ely again with Bumbleo. It's not Cavalier defense. That is good defense. And here's good ball movement. Tucker, he has a beautiful textbook form for those threes. He's able to knock that one in. Little pull-up J by Ahmad Henderson.
And Niagara's done a good job of limiting their mistakes and giving away possessions. And their win against the Stags, only 6 turnovers all game long. In that first half, the ratio, 11 assists to just 1 turnover. The distribution and passing of the ball for the Purple Eagles has been on point.
That backdoor cut there, and then the lay-in as Yawo Bangmensa thread the needle. Our final highlight right there, the three from Dre Bullock. And now the Purple Eagles back out on the floor. 39-33, we are going to step aside. Come right back after this quick timeout, folks. Second half action comes up next. And we welcome you back. Take a look at our players to watch update. Here's some first half highlight package. Ahmad Henderson, what a good opening 20 minutes. There you see the numbers. 9 points on 4 of 8 from the floor. Made just 1 of 4 3-pointers, but a three-level scorer, to be sure, is Ahmad Henderson. There you see a congratulatory handshake there from Dre Bullock. On the other side, Sean Duru-Gordon, he is halfway to his per-game average with 12 first-half points. Great shooting in the opening 20, Frank.
Yeah, 5 of 7 is fantastic. 2 of 2 from the line, which we're accustomed to seeing. But he also leads the team in rebounds. He's doubled the next highest 3, as he has 6 so far on the game. And that's just a testament, again, to how he can do everything all over the court. The one thing the Purple Eagles have done well, though, against Duru-Gordon is that double-team rotation, which has caused him to commit some turnovers.
4 turnovers in the opening half for Duru-Gordon. Let's take a look at some numbers, some outcomes when Niagara does the following. They shoot better than 50%. They're unbeaten, 46% today. 35% or better from three-point range, better than a 500 record. You can see they have surpassed that 35% threshold. Just 1 turnover, as Frank mentioned, and the Purple Eagles trying to get to 6-8 when they keep it under 15 turnovers.
And the last stat there, Niagara 4-1 when leading at halftime. Siena has had a tough time trying to come from behind. They're 0-11 when trailing after 20.
Well, here we go. Second half underway in the entry pass to Mason Courtney. And there's Ahmad Henderson trying to get the steal. Good job by Courtney to ward him off. The Saints, first possession. This is Gribben up top to Duru-Gordon. Now to Michael Ealy, again with Bumbleow lurking. Spins around, a 2 on the way. That one no good. Rebound to Ahmad Henderson. And Frank, late breaking news, I can tell you, there is the MAC Rookie of the Week, just announced by the league in the last 90 seconds. Ahmad Henderson II is the MAC Rookie of the Week. Away from the basketball, we have a whistle, and it looks as though Yao Obang-Mensah, there you see him just holding his left leg, and Yao will come off the floor. This has been, boy, a tough game for the Purple Eagles. Braxton Bayless exited the first half with an injury, and now Yao Obang-Mensah will get some attention from Purple Eagles athletic trainer John Monroe. So Quan Marble checks in.
Yeah, you hope it could just be a cramp because he's rubbing the calf, but tough to speculate. You just never know what's going on.
Bumbleow with it now along the baseline. Whips it up top to Quan. Quan takes it down low. Back to Luca. 3 on the way, but wait, we have a whistle, and stepping on the boundary was the Purple Eagles, Luke Bumbleow. So Niagara turns it over for just the second time tonight. But how about Ahmad Henderson, back-to-back weeks. That is his third time this season that the freshman from outside of Chicago has been named the MAC Rookie of the Week. Good news for the control room. They don't have to do a whole bunch of changes to the graphic for next week's games.
They need a post-it that says today is Monday. I'm like, they don't announce those on Sunday. No, we're a day ahead here.
Obi Oha, I believe, is going to get the foul. It is on Harlan, and that is just the first on Harlan. There's a good look at the interior game, and that last left lean, you could, with the left arm, you can see if you go straight up, we said that in the first half, you're okay, but when the big 7-footer brought that left limb over there and impacted Duru-Gordon, it'll send him to the line. In search of our first points since the intermission, free throw is good.
And when you're that big as Obi Oha is, you can't do anything subtly. They're going to pick up on every little thing you do, and that time the contact called.
Tom Massarello, as Gordon knocks down the second free throw, said he is a pure scorer. We've been able to move Duru-Gordon to different spots on the floor. It's just a different dynamic now for the Saints, with the 6th game having Duru-Gordon in the lineup. 4-point game. Henderson on the pass from Bumbleow. Ahmad Henderson taking down low. Now he goes to Bumbleow. Ealy was there on the catch. Luke leaves it on the doorstep for Obi Oha. Goes up, layup, no, but a foul. Obi Oha went strong to the cage. Draws the foul on Giovanni Emejuru.
And this is what we were talking about in the half, right? Be aggressive with it. Invite some contact. Obi Oha was going to make a strong move to the rim. Instead, he'll earn a trip to the line to shoot a pair.
Looking at it live, I thought perhaps, and Killian Gribben did the same thing, thought that perhaps he traveled, but that was a good, strong job keeping that left pivot foot, as now he does a good strong job with the left sneaker tie. So Obioha able to collect himself, and he'll go to the line for the first time today. 70% from the stripe for the Hoxie, Kansas native, and that one is good. Frank told you the first half, you know, this is a smooth stroke for Harlan Obioha. You think 7-footer, all he's going to do is dunk it. Not the case for this young man.
He gets a good rotation and spin off the fingertips. You might actually say he's more of an effective shooter from about 5-6 feet away rather than right by the rim.
Swishes that one in. He averages a double-double in conference play, does Obioha. And the Purple Eagles lead restored at 6. That's what it was at the intermission. That's back Duru now to Gribben. Gribben, one dribble, throw it on the block. Duru Gordon going to work now against Quant. Takes it center of the floor, rises up, left that one short. Rebound, battle for, and last touch by the Saints. Well, the Siena sideline looking for a push there.
Yeah, they might have an argument that Gribben was leaning on that line, but the Purple Eagles' strong push get another turnover.
Literally and figuratively from Frank there. I thought they did get away with one as well. Here is Ahmad into the front court, now to Bumbalo. Obioha really working hard down low, and that is a foul on Gribben. Boy, you can see just a burst from the baseline as Obioha posted up. He draws the foul on Gribben.
And I think that might be a little frustration from that call on the other end. You see the physical play just on the far left side of the screen, and Gribben gets rung up.
His first second team foul. Dribble handoff, Ahmad Henderson with it now. Ahmad, ball fake. Courtney not taking the bait, so Ahmad has to release it to Bumbalo. Shot clock now at 10. Luke crosses over, goes left, steps aside, a two on the way. That one off the iron, no good. Rebound tapped, out of bounds. Last touch by Niagara. It'll be Saints basketball.
Saints getting a big stop there. Niagara doing well. They continue to crash those boards looking for offensive rebounds. That time just out of the reach of Obioha, and ends up going to the Saints.
There's Gribben with it. Didn't hoist the three, nearly fumbled it away. Now up top, Evbagaru takes it down low, feeds Gribben, layup good. Great look there, one Saint to another.
The pass underneath, just tremendous. Diving lateral or to the floor, left-handed, and find the open man for an easy two.
Back down to a four-point game. Henderson with it against Courtney. Takes him down low, walks a tightrope in the baseline, bounce pass up top, Quan. Quan, oh, he had a path to the bucket, but dribbled it away. Now he'll go back towards the rim. Ball fake out to the defender in the air, and he lays it in. Quan Marble, his first field goal after pouring in a dozen on Friday night.
Had a terrific first move the first time he was trying to get to the lane, and it went away. What did he do? He just created another one with a quick sidestep to his right, then the quick move to his left led to the layup.
He's the ninth Purple Eagle to score today. And Bagdura gets caught off by the 7-footer, so the pass up top, Courtney. Right wing now. Evbagaru, and a foul on the entry pass to Gribben. That's a holding foul on Randy Tucker. For Randy, that is his second. Substitution for Niagara. Dre Bullock in. Randy Tucker will come out.
And we're seeing again this depth of the Niagara team. No player has played more than Bumbalo at 20, but you look at the Saints, you have three players over 20 minutes with Gribben knocking on the door with Ely and Duru Gordon all playing massive minutes so far.
Entry pass, shot missed, getting it back again, going up, and a foul as Evbagaru misfired on his first one from in tight, got his own rebound, and was fouled by Ahmad Henderson. There you see the miss. Shooter always first one to know, right? If it's not on the money, and then Ahmad says, I'm going to make you earn these two. And not a bad proposition here, as it's just about 50% from the stripe for the freshman from Scarborough, Ontario. And he swishes that in. 2 points in the game now. Scoreless 18 minutes for Evbagaru on Friday night, but he did chip in on the glass. 5 rebounds. And pouring over the Siena notes. How about he was his high school's valedictorian? Free throw on the way. No good. He knew it was off, though. That's how sharp he is. Into the front court comes the Purple Eagles. Henderson up top, Bumbalo. Again, Ely right there on the catch. As Luke had a couple of first half threes. Entry pass, Emmy off the window. That one no good. Battles for the rebound. Last touch, I think, by the Saints, and it is. Good work there by Rutai Siray, battling against Killian Gribben. And it went off of Gribben, so 20 on the shot clock.
Watch Six. Gribben try to box out right here, but Rutai Siray going to work around it and just get enough to get it off Gribben. Save the Niagara possession.
Juan taking it to the paint, off the window. Good, it settled through. Juan ended up on the seat of his pants. Niagara sideline looking for the and one, but the whistle never came. The lead is 7.
And there's the bench points again. Marble with back-to-back field goals for his group. And extends that Niagara lead out.
Juan came in hitting 18 of his last 27 field goals and now has hit 2. Duru Gordon to the rim, no good, but a foul. Second on Juan. It'll take us to our under 16-minute media timeout. Free throws when we come back. Purple Eagles leading it by 7. Juan Marble has been sensational. He's got Niagara's last 4 points. Come right back after this. And a good Monday afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome.
Every stitch has a story. Every product has a purpose. And every company has a brand. From the drawing board, the boardroom, to the field. Custom, quality, on time. Everyone is a customer. Everything you need is right here. Add Pro Sports, your branded merchandise solution.
Great seats at a great price. Get them safer, simpler, and smarter with Ticket Smarter. A proud partner to the biggest names in live sports and events, including ESPN events and iHeartRadio, Ticket Smarter has seats for over 125,000 live events and 48 million tickets for sale, all backed with the Ticket Smarter 100% ticket guarantee. Thinking about your next great live event? Think smarter. Think Ticket Smarter. Get your tickets your way guaranteed at TicketSmarter.com.
Discover the timeless magic of gifting at Firth Jewelers, a family tradition for 77 years. In every piece, you'll find more than just jewelry. You'll find a moment waiting to be created. Our fine jewelry tells your story. Our collection caters to all tastes and budgets, where quality meets affordability. 2435 Military Road in Niagara Falls, and go forth to Firth.
Welcome you back. Second half action here inside the Gallagher Center. The Siena Saints break their huddle. Niagara leading it by 7. I believe we have the MAC preseason poll. This was released in the fall as the coaches were all polled, and Siena was the number 4 pick. The Purple Eagles all the way down to number 9. And if you think about, look at that, St. Peter's 10th. They're perfect. They haven't lost yet this year. Ryder, a slow start, but Coach Baggett's club, a ton of talent. So that is the preseason poll. What folks thought in the summer and then into the fall. But now the real game's unfolding, including a good one for you here today on this Monday. Free throw swished in by Duru Gordon. Is there anything else that the young man needs to do? This is quite a performance. Our first look at Duru Gordon in person. 5 for 5 from the stripe, make him 6 for 6. That time he hit the rim.
I was just going to say, I don't think he hit the rim on any of them. That might have caught the back.
Yep. We're going to put an asterisk by that one. We'll count it anyway. 5-point game. Here is Mumbelow with the basketball. Runs Ely into a screen. Henderson with it now. Ahmad Henderson will ask Emmy to set the screen. He doesn't. Back pass to Emmy. A wide open 3 from the top. Rattles out. Good look there for Rutai Siray. He can hit that. Healy with it now, right wing. Takes Bumbleow down low. Shot on the way, no good. Rebound tapped up by Gribben. Gribben again, but Ahmad Henderson at 5'9" must have timed his jump perfectly. Into the corner. Bullock fakes a three. Takes it down low. Went for the dunk and he missed. Rebound to the Saints. Duru Gordon back the other way. Feeds it into Ely. Spins and lays it off the window. First bucket of the second half for Ely. It's a one possession game.
Yeah, Rutai Sire cleared the lane for Bullock. Got him to the rim. Just couldn't get the finish. And then on the other end, Siena able to convert. And just like that, back within three.
Saints trying to get to 2-3 in conference play. They're trying to snap Niagara's four-game win streak. Henderson in the corner. Dre's three on the way. No good. He overshot the rim. And there was Duru Gordon just waiting for it. Here's a chance for Siena to tie things up. Oh, falling to the floor is Mason Courtney. It is a traveling violation. He's going to be helped up. He's hobbling a little bit. And he's going to, I believe he's going to come off the floor. Here's the last bucket. There you see a little clear out there by Emmy. But then Dre got blocked by the rim. Gribben will check out along with Mason Courtney. Lance Irving on the floor for the Purple Eagles. He'll get his first minutes. And Ahmad Henderson, who seems like he has been on the court just about the entire game. He hasn't quite been, but now Ahmad on the sideline. So it's Bumbleow, Marble, Irving, Obioha, and Bullock. In the corner, Dre now goes along the baseline. Pulls up, six-footer, no good. Rebound, Obioha gets the offensive carry. Did he step on the line? Yes, he did. Harlan maybe looking for a little bit too much there instead of kicking it back out. Good work to get the offensive rebound, but the Purple Eagles turn it over.
Yeah, the Saints did well to get two defenders on that baseline. Limit the room that he had to operate. He wasn't going to be able to find an outlet pass. And that depth that we talked about with the Purple Eagles are dipping even further into their bench without Obing Mensah and Bayless available as of this moment.
Yet we see Yao on the stationary bike trying to stay loose, but he injured his leg, hasn't been back here. It happened early second half. Ev Bagger spinning in the paint to the bucket. Layup is good. What a finish there. Spinning four in the game for Ev Baggeru. And the Purple Eagle lead is shaved to one.
What a terrific move in that lane. Mentioned the spin. Got a little contact. Was able to go to the underhand scoop. And it's going to be a timeout taken by the Purple Eagles.
Niagara calls timeout. This will go as a full timeout. We will step aside with Niagara leading it by one. Oh, great spin move. Where'd he go? Ev Baggeru lays it in to make it 45-44 Purple Eagles. And we welcome you back. Then you see Randy Tucker in jersey number 1 and Yawo Bangmenza to his left in jersey 15. So if you're not sitting down in those chairs during the timeout, that means you're not coming back on the floor. We mentioned that Yao went out earlier in this second half. He was on the stationary bike for a little while. So the depth that the Purple Eagles talk a lot about, that will really be tested here on this Monday afternoon that seems like a Sunday. No doubt about it. Bills game to follow a little bit later today. And there you see Jason Bradwell visiting with Coach Paulus. So Niagara clinging to a one-point lead. Bullock, Obioha, Rutai Siré, Henderson, and Lance Irving. So it was a quick rest for Ahmad. A timeout by the Purple Eagles. Coach Paul is saying, you know what, I'm not going to wait till the under 12-minute media. Entry pass to Obioha. They're unable to connect, and the Purple Eagles turn it over. Harlan did have an advantage here. His defender, Emma Juru, did not know that the ball was on its way, but the pass unable to be completed. And Bagaroo now to Emma Juru. He's not played a ton. Throw it to Duru Gordon, backing down Lance Irving. Settles for a two, and it's good. Duru Gordon just setting up Lance Irving there. 18 in the game, and a look for one more after the foul is called on Irving.
And that's tough for Irving. Just getting into the game, and you're spotting up against their purest shooter. Very minimal contact, but enough to draw the whistle and a chance at the three-point play. And now it's an 8-0 run for Siena over the course of the last 3 minutes.
Not a lot there. I'm with you. That free throw is swished in. Duru Gordon just putting the Saints on his shoulders. Siena has only made 4 buckets here in this second half.
Duru Gordon, though, 5 from the line alone.
Henderson shot no good. The Purple Eagles have only made 2 in a low-scoring start here. 13-6, the Saints outscoring Niagara here since the intermission. And Ahmad Henderson will go to the line and shoot 2. The foul is on Ely, his first team's 3rd. And during one of the stoppages, the public address announcer, Fred Queso, did announce to the crowd that Ahmad was the recipient of back-to-back MAC Rookie of the Week honors. So as the building gets quiet, free throw good by Ahmad. First trip to the stripe for Ahmad Henderson. The Purple Eagles now just 3 free throw attempts in the game. And give Ahmad Henderson double figures. He has 12 now. Second one is also good.
Some big points for the Purple Eagles while they're going through this lull in their shooting and getting to the lines, a way to work through that, see if they can continue to try to draw some fouls against the Saints.
Fourth tie of the ball game, deadlocked at 47. Tekken spins back to Ely. Didn't hoist the 3. Henderson rose up to refute that. Here's Tekken in the paint, steps to his right. Now to Ely. 5 to shoot. Ely, a contested 2 is money.
Just picture perfect, created the space for himself. He's been just a pure shooter here today for Ely.
With more than 12 minutes left here in the second half, Ely has hit his average at 14. Overplay there on Henderson. In the corner, Bullock didn't shoot the 3. Takes it down low. Around Duru Gordon, shot no good, and a rebound to the Saints, Duru Gordon.
That time the Saints were conceding the 3, but Niagara looked to drive, and they were able to make the stop.
And Bagaroo misfires. And what do we have here? Obioha was off balance, and free throws upcoming. Emi Rutai Siré will step in front of Harlan there. He looked back at Emma Juru. There was some contact in the paint. We know that there are free throws upcoming when we come back. 11:59 left. There you see the last bucket for the Saints. Michael Ely gives the Saints the lead. take a peek at our Voco, the Cadence, out of town scoreboard. Iona did come back to defeat Mount St. Mary's yesterday. Marist really hammered the Ryder Bronx on the home floor of the Red Foxes at McCann Arena in Poughkeepsie. St. Peter's walked into Manhattan and remained unbeaten, defeating the Jaspers. And this game on the go right now in the second half at the Kessler Athletic Center. And the Fairfield Stags, who struggled from the floor on Friday night, well, they are taking it out on Reggie Witherspoon's club as Fairfield leads Canisius by 25. Our newest corporate partner, Voco, the Cadence Hotel. If you're looking to round out your stay in the Niagara Falls area, whether you're visiting the Falls or perhaps an event here at Niagara University, we're on Rainbow Boulevard in the Falls. Check them out online, VocoTheCadence.com. Free throw good by Evbagaru. And this is the largest lead of the ball game for the Saints, 50-47. There you see a tick under 12 minutes left. Free throw no good. Rebound Bumbleau.
And this is where you look for Bumbleau to spot up for a big three, really try to get the team in gear, but Tekken having none of it.
Yeah, steal by Tekken, and he lays it in. Zach Tekken now with five. Purple Eagles just not as sharp as they have been in this four-game win streak. Now they trail it by five. A lot of time left.
One turnover in the first half. They have four here in the second half.
Randy Tucker off the screen. Goes right wing to Ahmad. He's got a three on the way. Off the iron, no good. Long rebound to Kwan. Kwan flips it to Ahmad. The freshman, good move. High off the window, good. He couldn't see the rim, but he knows how to get things done.
He knows where that basket is intuitively, and he was able to somehow guide that ball through a lot of limbs off the glass and in.
Tekken to Ely. Ely now to Duru Gordon. He'll pull up, and two on the way is swished in by Sean Duru Gordon. He will be the last one to leave Western New York. What a weekend he is having.
Shooting 70% from the floor here today. And has nine rebounds to boot.
Henderson lost his balance, rolls out to Tucker. He's got a three on the way, around and out, no good. Rebound Ely. Purple Eagles trailing it by five.
Niagara's had some terrific looks from behind the arc. Can't get him to go. One for the last six. 5 of 16 so far in the day.
Siena had a brief lead on Friday night. It's a steal. Tucker leaves it now to Ahmad. Ahmad's got Bumbleau on his right, Kwan on his left. He goes to Kwan. Layup is good. Count it. And an opportunity for one more for Kwan Marble.
That's six for him in the second half. Good look off by Henderson. There you see the help coming late. And that was a tough pass from the real end. Didn't have a lot of time to get that shot off. But now a chance at the old-fashioned three-point play.
Well, Purple Eagles need something like that, little jolt of a three-point play. If Kwan can convert 70% from the stripe, is Kwan Marble the second. Trying to make a two-point game, and he does. He swishes that one in. 7 second-half points for Kwan.
Yeah, he leads all Niagara scorers. There's only been three here in the second half. When we saw him in the first half, everyone getting involved. The scoring's been centralized right now.
Tekken with it. Niagara 1-3-1 defensive set here. First time we've seen it today. Pass in the post. Emajuru no good, but a reach and foul. I think that'll be on Harlan, and I think he is no problem doing that one. Not going to let Emajuru lay run in. He'll have to earn it from the stripe, where he's 58% coming in. He is 1 for 2 here today.
That foul does put Siena in the single bonus, though. So any non-shooting fouls will be a 1-1.
Emajuru, who leads the Saints in minutes. A left-handed release, and that one is good. A Siena team that does not shoot free throws well coming into this building. 60% on the season. Right now they are at 75% in this game. 12 makes to just 4 misses. Mason Courtney back in. Ely will sit down. Although he hasn't sat down yet. He's talking to his head coach, Carm Massarello. That free throw rattles out, no good. Rebound, Harlan Obioha for the Purple Eagles. 7th rebound of the game for the Big O. And that leads the Purple Eagles. Bumbleau with it. Now to Harlan. One possession game. Dribble handoff Ahmad. Thought about a three. Puts it on the deck. Through the paint. Floater on the way. That one no good. Rebound tapped up, but then secured by Duru Gordon.
Yeah, Henderson thought maybe he'd get the contact call. But Siena did well to stay with their feet planted. Straight vertical base. Threw the shot off just enough.
It isn't often where the Purple Eagles have more team fouls than their opponent. Pass down low. Dewar Gordon hangs in the air. Good job without fouling. Good defense without fouling by Randy Tucker. Seven fouls on the Purple Eagles. Just four for the Saints. Bumbleow a three on the way. That one no good. Too strong. Rebound to the Saints. Outlet to Tekken. Emajuru down the other end of the floor. It's knocked out of bounds by Kwan. Good work there by Kwan Marble Jr. Substitution for the Purple Eagles. Lance Irving going to check in. And Randy Tucker will come out. Here we'll take a look at Tekken down low. Great feed to Duru Gordon, but there it is. We said it countless times. You go straight up, you're okay, and that's what Tucker did. Duru Gordon down low, laying good over Marble, and he will go to the line for a three-point play opportunity. The foul on Kwan. I have that as his third.
And he is just a difference maker, Todd. He gets to that rim, gets the contact. You see, Marble Jr. thought he had stayed just completely straight up. Did not. Duru Gordon has a chance now to hit his season average if he sinks this free throw.
Average 23.8. This will be point number 24 if it goes through, and you knew it was going to. 12 in the first half. 12 in the second half. Bagaru will come out. Killian Gribben back in. Largest lead of the ball game. And mentioned that, pardon me, Siena led for just a possession at Canisius. Mason Courtney had back-to-back threes, put him in the lead with about 5 minutes left, and then Canisius came back. There's a foul away from the basketball. So when you're 2-13 and you've lost 8 in a row, the foul on the Saints goes on Zach Tekken. You don't play with the lead a lot, and there's something to that. We'll see how Siena does, trying to get this one into the win column. Duru Gordon will check out. That hasn't happened much at all, but the luxury of a 6-point advantage and the under 8-minute media coming up. Good catch there by Harlan on the entry pass.
That was a good 30-second rest for Ely.
Henderson now to Bumbleow. Whistle away from the ball again, and that's a foul on the Saints. So the team fouls beginning to even up. Giovanni Emajuru, and that is the third on Emajuru. Niagara needs one more foul against the Saints. The next time it is a non-shooting foul, it'll be a 1-1. Entry pass to Kwan. Dribble handoff, loop, back pass, Kwan Marble. Fake the three, got the defender in the air, to the bucket, and swatted away by Emajuru. Boy, even though back-to-back fouls, Gio went up strong and able to swat that one away. Look at this.
Missing is the volleyball net. Spike.
What a play that was. Entry pass to Kwan. One dribble now behind the back. Taking Gribben down low. Emajuru is lurking. Marble now to Luke. Five to shoot, though. Bumbleow pulls up. Free throw line. Jumper is good. Great help from his teammates. Ahmad Henderson let him know what was on the shot clock, and it's a four-point game.
That ball had some arch and hang time, and it went splash.
A whistle before the shot by Emajuru. The foul is on Obi Oha. And now for Harlan, that is his third. Take a look at the last bucket. Bumbleow again. Look how high. Nearly got outside of the shot there of the camera, but it rang through. And we said it before, Bumbleow, he doesn't need to be in perfect up and down. He can be off balance. He might even prefer it. Amajuru's free throw is good. And that is a 1-1, so he has earned the back end. Amajuru now 3 points. They've all been from the stripe.
6'11", 265, a big presence in the middle of that Siena formation out of England and a transfer from Sam Houston University.
Bullock and Tucker in for Niagara. Irving and Kwan Marble out. Free throw on the way. They're going to wave this off anyway, I believe. Too much movement on the line by Killian Gribben, so wipe away the free throw. 8:18 left. It stays a 5-point lead. Those are things you can't have happen when you're trying to snap a long losing streak. We'll see if it matters. Obi Oha with a backdoor cut by Bullock. Couldn't get him the ball. So Ahmad Henderson with the catch. He's got a three on the way. That one no good off the iron. All yellow underneath. And that is Michael Ely with the rebound. Back Bagaru around Obioha. Back up top, Ely. He's got a three on the way, and that one is good. And here come the Saints. They lead it now by eight, their largest lead. Ely with 17. Is this the springboard win that the Saints have been looking for? Bullock fakes the three, takes down low, feeds it to Obioha, and he slams it through. What a feed from Dre Bullock, and Harlan Obioha says, hang on a minute.
And that put down could get that Niagara bench up and running. They've been struggling offensively. One for their last eight from behind the arc. Need to find their offensive touch in a hurry.
As Bagaru with it now, right wing goes along the baseline. Bullock trying to beat him. Spinning, shot on the way, good. What a move there by Bagaru. His sixth point here in this second half. 8-point game again. Right in front of the Niagara bench, and a foul. That will send Randy Tucker to the line to shoot the 1-1 when we come back. There's a timeout on the floor. We will step aside as well. Up top, Ely with the big three. Back come the Purple Eagles. Obioha with a rim rattler. Niagara down eight.
Discover the timeless magic of gifting at Firth Jewelers. A family tradition for 77 years. In every piece, you'll find more than just jewelry. You'll find a moment waiting to be created. Our fine jewelry tells your story. Our collection caters to all tastes and budgets, where quality meets affordability. 2435 Military Road in Niagara Falls. And go forth to Firth.
What do you expect from that first job out of college? Working your way up from the bottom? Instead, how does this sound? Starting in a guaranteed leadership position with people who look to you for guidance because you're trained to give it and make important decisions in critical situations. Skip entry level. Decide to lead as an Army officer.
At Niagara University, success runs through us. The opportunities available at NU will give you the clarity you need to pursue your passion. With more hands-on experience from the start, you'll feel like you're on the right career path right away. See how NU sets you up for success at niagara.edu.
Every stitch has a story. Every product has a purpose. And every company has a brand. From the drawing board, to the boardroom, to the field. Custom, quality, on time. Everyone is a customer. Everything you need is right here. Add Pro Sports, your branded merchandise solution.
Take a look at some highlights here of Sean Duru-Gordon. He has been named our Castle Products Rebounder of the Game. There you see some of the 10 caroms, 9 off the defensive glass, brought to you by Castle Products. Look for Castle's streak-proof glass available at Delta Sonic, Tops, and Wegmans. The young man has done it all. We may see a highlight reel of him a little bit later as well, as he has helped surge the Saints into an 8-point lead.
And what has to be frustrating for the Purple Eagles, they've done such a good job of boxing out on the defensive boards, limiting Siena's offensive rebounds to just 4 today. But the Saints have been able to make up for it because they're shooting lights out, 24-40, 60% from the floor here today. Not to mention a great job at the line, 14 of 20.
Free throw no good by Randy Tucker. Has not attempted many free throws. A chance for the Saints. Leading it by 8. Ely loops the pass to Courtney. We're inside of 7 minutes. There are the Saints. Emma Juru steps out. Obioha stays in the paint. Ely with it now. It has been a two-man show here for the Saints. Ev Bagaru taking it down low. His floater around and out, no good. Gets his own rebound and able to finish. 6:20 left. The lead is 10.
And that was one of those few offensive rebounds Niagara gave up, but quickly led to 2 points.
Bullock, a three from the top, is good. Very calmly waiting for that pass from his teammate. Dre Bullock was his second triple. Give him 8 now for the game, and the Purple Eagles hanging around. 6 minutes left.
Of 1 of 8 shooting by Niagara firm, 3-point land.
Bagaru again to the 10, and that one drops through. Looked like that was going to come off to the weak side, but it dropped through.
He has 8 in the second half, does he, Bagaru? Because he has 6 field goals and a couple of free throws, and now you got 3 big scores that Niagara has to worry about.
Bullock faked the 3, takes it down low. OBO hot ball fake shot, no, but a foul. They'll make Harlan go to the line and earn his 2 points. The foul is on the Saints.
And it's amazing when you get the shooting of Juru Gordon and then Ely, it opens up things in the lane because you're worried about those shooters on the outside. You get opportunities down low just like that as the Bagaru is able to make that one fall.
Harlan's free throw, that'll have to hurry. Left it short. And the Purple Eagles just off a little bit here on this Monday afternoon. 42% from the floor, 31% from three-point range. And Obioha trying to split a pair from the line. See if Niagara does any full court pressure after this. Free throw on the way is good. They will. Little 1-2-1-1. Full court trap by the Purple Eagles. Tekken with it in the corner. Stolen by Marble. Left wing, Ahmad. He's got a 3 on the way. Good! Well, they sprung the trap. It's a 5-point game. Henderson rains down that 3. Oh, and a whistle and a foul, says Jason Bradwell.
And those are the type of plays that can change games. As Niagara gets the turnover they were looking for, and then they get a drain 3. There's the 2-man trap. Turnover, great look off. Find Henderson behind the arc, open 3. And the 2-time rookie of the week in succession able to sink it. But because Siena's in that bonus, foul called against Bulligan. Brings free throws in the other direction.
Double bonus, 2 free throws upcoming for Zach Tekken. 1 for 2. And now making 2 for 3. 6 points in the ball game for the sophomore. Make it a 3 possession game. Gribben will check in. Emajuru will come out. Shortened bench here for the Purple Eagles. Couple players have not returned from injury. Malik Edwards not quite 100%, so Malik not dressed again today for Niagara. Free throw good by Tekken. The lead is 7. And a Purple Eagles team who poured in 96 points in victory on Friday night. Henderson to the bucket, reverse layup, no, unable to spin it home, but he will go to the line and shoot 2. The foul is on Killian Gribben.
He's just fearless. He has no qualms about going into that paint. Gets the contact and is able to earn a trip to the line to shoot 2. He wanted that and 1.
Yeah.
So close, but now he has to get it done from the line.
If you look at the game over the full span of just about 35 minutes, Siena has been better for longer stretches, and that's why they enjoy the lead that is now shaved to 6 as Ahmad knocks in yet another free throw.
Another make here would give them 20 points back-to-back games.
And as mentioned earlier, just announced as the MAC Rookie of the Week winner, back-to-back weeks for Ahmad Henderson, 3rd time this season. More backcourt pressure. Gribben holds it high over his head, finds Duru Gordon right away to Tekken. Now the Saints have numbers, but good job by Randy Tucker to cut off Ely. Pass down low, Gribben by himself, and he slams it through.
Purple Eagles got caught looking at the basketball. Loss of responsibility down low. Gribben able to find the soft spot.
Pretty good patience also by Siena. The lead is 7. Ahmad through the double team and a blocking foul on the Saints. It'll be their 10th team foul. There were a pair of Saints in the area, and the foul's going to go on Mason Courtney. A look at slipping the screen is Killian Gribben, and he is by his lonesome. Not going to miss from there. That'll help the field goal percentage. So Ahmad Henderson, he will shoot 2 with it being the 10th foul. So double bonus for both teams the rest of the way. And that free throw good by Henderson. 20 points last game out, as Frank said, that was against Fairfield. 17 in the first half, that really blew the game open. They kept him quiet in the second half. Ahmad didn't play his usual minutes. That free throw also good. Six of Ahmad's points here are from the free throw line. Again, a five-point game. Now the Purple Eagles, man-to-man defense. They have pulled the trap out. Bagaroo with it now. Niagara switches defenders. Randy Tucker picks him up. Bagaroo takes him down low. Floater is good. It drops in again. He's had some good fortune for Bagaroo. Niagara, not an answer for him. He's got 12 in the second half.
Yeah, he's just been so impressive, backing down his defenders, showing the touch at the rim to get the finish as well.
Ahmad, his reverse layup, that one rims out. You wonder, that has got to be the difference of Yao Bangmenza on the floor in the game versus today. He is on the sideline. You've got to think, if Bagaroo would be staring into the chest of Yao Bangmenza. Yes, the Purple Eagles switch defenders a lot. Here's Tucker on Obangmensah. Ely fakes a three. Ball fake, throw it into the post. Gribben, and a reach-in foul on Luke Bumbelow. And that'll take us to our under four-minute media timeout. The Saints can see the finish line, leading it 74-67. 3:55 left. We head to the break, but not before the finish here in tight again by the Scarborough, Ontario native. 20-point club. These are consecutive games, folks, as today is the ninth consecutive game that Niagara has had a 20-point scorer. The first six, it was six different players. They were the only team in the country that could boast that. But they are going to need a little bit more from who's ever out on the floor as the Purple Eagles trailing Siena by seven. Larry C. Ahmad Henderson leading the way, 22 points in the game today. So here we go. The Saints, they will send Killian Gribben to the line. He doesn't get there a lot either. 3-for-5 on the season. He will shoot two.
And you mentioned the Purple Eagles need scores. That's absolutely true. But can they find a stop defensively? Right now, Siena 8 for their last 9 on field goals. And they continue to do a terrific job at the free throw line. It's 17 points from the charity stripe so far.
If he makes this one, they'll be 75% from the line, and they are 18 for 24. And you absolutely need to take advantage of those free tosses. The lead is 9. Emi Rutaisire has checked in for the Purple Eagles. Catches a pass now, top of the key. Dribble handoff, Bumbelow. Back up top, Kwan. Kwan taking it down low with a step on the defender, and he lays it in. Good play there by the Purple Eagles. Kwan now has 9. Duru Gordon back on the floor for the Saints. He had a chance to get a couple of minutes rest there.
All 9 of those points for Kwan have been here in the second half.
And Bagaroo going to take Emmy down low. Spins, gets cut off, so the pass up top, Ely. Ely, left side of the lane, had it knocked away. Bullock comes away with it for the Purple Eagles. Right wing pass to Kwan, nearly lost his balance. Niagara with numbers as Ely is a little bit injured. To Emmy, a three from the corner. No good. Tapped up by Kwan. That missed. And the rebound to Duru Gordon, but we have a reach-in foul on Niagara. The foul, I believe, is on Kwan Marble. It is, and free throws upcoming.
Purple Eagles get that big defensive stop that they're looking for. Open three from the corner. Just can't go. Would have made it a four-point game, and then the foul at the end there leads to free throws in the other direction, and you don't want number one taking free throws.
Not
he
at
has been
all.
Deadly.
3:03 left. Niagara running out of time. Duru Gordon was 8 for 10 on Friday night. He is 8 for 8 tonight. Purple Eagles fans want to see him at 8 for 10 here again today. Free throw on the way is good. He rattled that one in. Duru Gordon, who might be looking at a future MAC player of the week. He's on the way, and that one is good. So he gets them both 10 for 10 from the line. Oh, by the way, he also chipped in with 12 rebounds on Friday night. He's got 10 rebounds here today. Back-to-back double-doubles in Western New York. In the corner, Emmy's three. Off the iron, no good. Dances across the rim, and Duru Gordon rips away the rebound. Siena can make it a double-digit game and get that much closer to picking up the win and snapping their eight-game losing streak. Duru Gordon has it. Cut off by Emmy.
Great job to get that back in between the circles. Utilize the shot clock. Take some time away from the Purple Eagles.
Ribbon to Duru Gordon. Niagara needs a stop. Six to shoot. Back up top, Ely with help from his bench. He glanced at the shot clock. A three on the way. No good. Rebound battled for, and over the back goes Hevbagaru. And Luke Bumbelow will go to the line. He will shoot two. I'll tell you what. It was a good-looking three for Ely from the corner. It danced off the rim.
That is personal foul number five on that play.
That's a big one. Hevbagaru will come out. Here's a look at the three. And over the top goes Hevbagaru. Niagara benefiting from good textbooks block out there by Luke Bumbelow, and he will go to the line and shoot two. Luke on the season, just about 90%. He tied his season high on Friday night. Seven assists for the Indiana native. Hails from Newcastle.
Quite the second half, though, put together by Michael Hevbagaru, because he ends up with 10 all in the second half. And he was just great at just driving the lane, gave Siena an option in the paint, and that's where they've been able to make their hay here today.
Purple Eagles not only need to take advantage of these free throws, and first one good by Luke as it slithers over the rim, but there are two main scorers on the floor, Duru Gordon and Michael Ely. Niagara has to concentrate on those two, try and shut them down if they're going to get back in this one. They now trail it by seven. There's enough time, but not the luxury of time for the Purple Eagles. Over the timeline they come. Duru Gordon now to Ely. Bangs into Kwan. No call up top. Duru Gordon didn't hoist a three. Left elbow jumper settles in. The generous rim to our right.
Had that soft touch to get the shooter's roll. Up to 28.
Timeout for the Purple Eagles. 2 minutes left. No indication yet if this is a 30 or a full timeout. It'll go as a full timeout. There you see the look of Duru Gordon and dancing around and dropping through points 27 and 28 for Duru Gordon. And I'll tell you what, that waiver appeal from the NCAA couldn't come soon enough for the Siena Saints. This is a different club with Duru Gordon on the floor as you see the Purple Eagles huddle.
9 of 13 shooting, all field goals, nothing from behind the arc, and of course 10 of 10 from the free throw line. Throwing those 11 rebounds, and yeah, you have a difference maker there for the Saints, and all of a sudden everything starts clicking into position. You get Ely contributing offensively. You're able to create some space down low for other players like Hevbagaru and Emajuru. So just his addition to the Siena lineup opens up things for his teammates, along with him chipping in 28 along the way.
16 of his 28 in the second half, and 12 of Hevbagaru's 13 in the second half. Ely has been with seven contributing, but not quite to the level of those two players. And Niagara trailing it by nine. A tick of the clock inside of 2 minutes. We'll see if the Purple Eagles have another surge in it. We saw earlier in the game they ran off seven straight in about 45 seconds is all it took. So they have the horsepower to do it. And Quan Marble will inbound. Joined on the floor by Dre Bullock, Ahmad Henderson, Harlan Obioha, and Luke Bumbleau. Michael Lealy still kind of looks like he's favoring that right side of his leg. Bumbleau up top to Ahmad. Ahmad Henderson picks up a dribble. Dre, a deep three, no good. It rimmed out. Rebound battled for, and it goes to the Saints. Minute 45 left. Duru Gordon away from the steal attempt by Marble. Spinning through the lane, and he lays it in. And it might be too much. Duru Gordon here for the Purple Eagles. 30 again. He ties his career high. Bumbleau leaves it to Quan. Up and under. Layup is good. 9-point game again. Good feed there by Bumbleau.
It was such a good move by Duru Gordon in the air. The last trip down, adjustment to his right for the easy two.
Ribbon to Duru Gordon, reaching in, tying it up, and we have a jump ball, and the arrow favors the Purple Eagles. Not done yet with a minute 16 left. Siena has three timeouts. There you see. Slick ball handling by Duru Gordon. All the way to the bucket and gets the roll. Minute 16 left. I think it has to be three-point shooting by the Purple Eagles now, and Siena certainly well aware of that. Bumbleau has to go into the post. Now to Quan, goes up, layup. No good, he missed it. Gets his own rebound. Looking for help, ball fake. Got the defender in the air in the and one. Emma Juru came down, but Quan able to muscle it through. He's got 13.
What patience shown that time. Waiting. He knew someone was going to make a move, couple of fakes. Nope, there's the contact. Chance at three, the old-fashioned way. And what a second half put together by Quan Marble.
Lance Irving's going to come in. Harlan Obioha will come out. One free throw up coming for Quan. This can make it a two-possession game. 64 seconds left. Niagara will insert Randy Tucker if this free throw goes through. It does. Swished in by Quan. So Randy Tucker, a very accomplished three-point shooter, will check in. Full court pressure by the Purple Eagles. Siena with three timeouts remaining. Niagara with just one. The arrow favors the Saints. There's a pass through the hands of Duru Gordon, and the Saints turn it over. It took just 2 seconds, and the turnover will give it back to Niagara.
After the Purple Eagles forced so many turnovers in the first half, Siena has been great with the basketball in the second half, but a turnover comes up at the worst of times, an opening of the door for the Purple Eagles if they can find points on this possession.
You don't necessarily have to hit a three, just need points in a hurry. Entry pass to Quan. He'll leave it for Luke. Luke, a three on the way. No good. That one grazed in front of the iron, and the rebound to the Saints. They definitely were going for the three, and a blocking foul there on Quan Marble the second. That'll be the fifth for Quan. What an effort there by the grad student from Denver as we take a look at, you'll see the screen set by Quan off the dribble, handoff, and just short. Another high arcing three-point attempt by the Purple Eagles, and Coach Paul is going to use as much of the 30 seconds as he is allotted to insert a substitute for Quan Marble, who has fouled out.
He was such a spark for the Tiger team. 14 points in the second half for him, and Purple Eagles are going to look for someone else to find the hot hand in this final moment if they're still entertaining the idea of coming back in this.
Yeah, I think they'll need some help from the Saints if they're going to do it. They'll need Siena to miss on free throws, because if Niagara can't get a steal, they will foul right away the rest of the way. Here are two more opportunities for Duru Gordon, who hasn't missed from the stripe today. A couple of dribbles is all he takes. And that one good. The perfect rotation, the difference between good and not good.
Apparently the rim is just part of the basket for him, because even when it touches the rim, it's going through. It has that shooter's touch.
This one on the way, not nearly as exciting. He swished it in. The lead is 8. Siena, a 30-second timeout. So So we'll keep things right here.
It was there for the Purple Eagles all game long. They're such a good three-point shooting team. But today, 7 of 24 from behind the arc, just under 30% as a team. You get one or two of those in your direction, and we're looking at just a two-point game, but haven't been able to get them to fall here today.
There you see the game reset, our score, with Siena leading it by 8, each team in the double bonus. Important there that the arrow favors Siena, should there be a tie-up. But this game, you know, representative of so many in the MAC, if you don't bring your best effort, anybody can lose on any day in this conference. Doesn't matter if you're undefeated St. Peter's or you're struggling like Siena has been, losing 8 in a row. But they were talking about, when will that full 40 minutes be? They played a great 20 minutes in the second half against Canisius. Coach Massarello said probably their best 20 minutes in a long time.
Todd, they had 48 hours to self-scout. They had a lot of good film sessions that they're able to look at what they've been doing and build off of it.
Bumble to Tucker, his three, no good. Left it short, rebound battled for Duru Gordon, the last to touch it, unable to save it before it goes out of bounds. Now that was another good look from three for the Purple Eagles, but just not going through, as Niagara has struggled from the deep perimeter here today. Just 28%, 7 of 25, and the Purple Eagles use their final timeout. Well, that is uncharacteristic for the top three-point shooting team in the MAC, who hit 67% on Friday. Now, that's an outlier because the Purple Eagles were on fire. 47% against Iona, 30% at Manhattan. On the road at UB, the Purple Eagles knocked in 31%. They have not been in the 20s in a long time, and it might be part of the reason that Siena walks out of here with the win.
And then with Siena, complete opposite. They've only attempted 4 three-pointers all game long. Everything's been in the half-court offense. Everything's been inside, using the paint. They've been terrific down low today as the Siena and Saints team, and it's so far has them in position looking to get the W on the road.
It'll be their first road win if they get it. The Siena Saints team averages 60 points a game. They are sitting on 84. Tucker inbound to Henderson. He's got a corner three, and that is good. Well, that one coming down from the rafters, and Ahmad Henderson keeping Niagara's hopes alive. It's a five-point game. Pass under the floor. Purples will foul Emma Juru. They do foul him right away. That's who they wanted to foul. 58% on the season is Emma Juru, and he is just 3 for 6 tonight. You talk about a tough three. A defender with a hand in his face is Mason Courtney at his hand up, and Ahmad Henderson perfectly positioned behind the arc. So a two-shot opportunity here for Emma Juru. You knew the Purple Eagles weren't going to run away without a last-minute surge. Emma Juru, 2 free throws. First one on the way is good. This is a big one. This makes it a 3-possession game if he can knock this one in. Emi Rutai-Sire will check in for the Purple Eagles. Obi Oha out. Well, here we go. Big free throw here with just 38.2 left. The big lefty. It's swished in. Emma Juru, 2 critical free throws. 7-point game. Here's Ahmad. Stop and go. Move all the way to the bucket. Finger roll good. Niagara down by 5. Niagara looking for a turnover. Emma Juru throws it out of bounds. It will be Niagara basketball. Do not go anywhere. We talked about how tough it is to finish it out when you haven't played with a lead for very long in the last 10 games or so. You'll see the turnover here as Emma Juru thought it was going to be an immediate return pass to his teammate, but into the Purple Eagles sideline it went. Down by 5. You take a 2 or a 3, whatever it is, you need it quick. Give and go. Tucker to the bucket. Layup good. It's a 3-point game. Niagara within a possession. Inbounds play, Courtney. Courtney knocked away. This will be Purple Eagle basketball. Yes, it is. They force another turnover.
It hasn't been the shooting that's done the Saints in. It's the turnovers. All of a sudden, they've made some bad decisions with the ball. Here comes the double team. Courtney has it knocked away by Henderson, and then he knocked it out of bounds themselves. Shot clock off, three-point game. Interesting to see what Greg Paulus styles up for his crew. Who's going to take that shot?
Niagara with the basketball. They have 20 on the shot clock. It wouldn't matter. Again, it's not going to be 30. So Niagara down by three. Here we go. Henderson with it. Trying to shake free of Courtney. Takes it down low. Layup good. One-point game. Niagara within one. 86-85 and a timeout by the Saints. Well, thanks for sticking with us, folks. The Purple Eagles making a late run at this. And Ahmad Henderson now with 29.
If it wasn't for all the rookie of the week accolades, you would forget that he's a freshman.
Right.
He just plays the game at such a high level, knows that Siena was guarding against the three. What does he do? He goes down low and takes the easy two. And now options there for the Purple Eagles to try to get the steal or the foul. No matter what, you're looking at a one possession game, even if they make both. And he has been special here today and honestly for the last few weeks.
There is one turnover a couple of times ago. There is another one that leads to points for Ahmad Henderson. He now has 29, a new career high for the freshman. He had 28 in his Gallagher Center debut back on November 11th against Bucknell that set a record. The highest performance for a freshman making his debut in this building. And tonight he's done one better, leading the Purple Eagles. Now they've charged back to within one. Henderson has 29. Again, the arrow favors the Saints. There is an intent look on Luke Bumbolo's face.
And no one on the Purple Eagles that'll be on the floor has four fouls. So anyone can take the foul when it's the best time without worrying about fouling out.
What an incredible surge here by the Purple Eagles.
We were thinking mid-60s, low-70s for this one. Didn't think we'd get to mid-80s between these two teams. Yet here we are.
80s game favors the Purple Eagles. Niagara on a 9-2 run in the last, get this, 45 seconds. Shot clock dark, 16.4 left. Duru Gordon can run the baseline. He gives it to Ely, then right back to Duru Gordon. Purple Eagles reaching in, trying to get the steal, but they commit the foul, and that is so heads up by the Saints to have the ball be inbounded to Duru Gordon. A great play to bring Ely outside of the court, put him out of bounds. Duru Gordon, critical for him. He established his presence inside the boundaries and then got that pass, and Niagara didn't have to foul right away because it's a one possession game. Whether or not Duru Gordon makes 0-1 or both of these, two shot opportunity. And again, he hasn't missed all day. That one settles through. 33 is his new career high.
A great inbound play designed during that timeout taken by Carmen Mazzarello and his group to secure Duru Gordon at the line.
Next free throw swish. Timeout by Siena. 13.6 seconds left. Niagara down by three. 30-second timeout, so we'll keep things right here. And this brings you to the age-old question: do you foul right away and prevent the opponent from attempting a three that would tie it up? And if you go back all the way back to our keys to the game and wanting to guard the three-point line against the Purple Eagles, so if you're going to try and first guess, we're not going to second guess, I think he's going to foul. I don't think he's going to let the Purple Eagles get a look at a three. Yes, Niagara is 8-for-26 today. That means 18 misses. But the fellas in purple and white have that shooter's mentality, their thought process being, well, the next one's going in. We'll see if they get a shot at it.
Well, they have two primary options when you're thinking three-pointers, right? You have Ahmad Henderson, who's been just fantastic with 29 points. And, of course, always lurking in the shadows, there is Luke Bumbolo. He can pop at any time from any distance. So, for Siena, those are your two keys. If it's not there for the Purple Eagles, they're going to have to create their own space, and Bumbolo's great at that.
Here we go, Bumbolo, and he is fouled. A reach out and grab a hold. Michael Ely did that to Luke Bumbolo. You just had to feel that was going to be the approach. So the foul on Ely, that's just his second. And here is Luke to go to the line. And again, this is not a spot where you want to make one, miss one. You want to make both of these. Luke's first one. That'll have to hurry, and it's good. Just enough to get over. Niagara within one. No doubt the pressure will be forthcoming. We'll see what play the Saints run again. All contingent upon Luke knocking this one in. No good. It rimmed out. Rebound, Ely. Ely is fouled right away by Ahmad Henderson. And a missed free throw could make it a two-possession game the next time Niagara gets the ball is Michael Ely, who is 79% from the stripe. For Ely, this will be his first trip to the line. These are pressure-packed for the sophomore.
Rumble's such a good free-throw shooter, too. Came into today's action, just missing two on the season. That one just rattled out.
Ely needs them both to make it a two-possession game. That one is too strong. You knew it on the release. You got to be alert on the lane if you are the Purple Eagles. Maybe this one gets a little tougher after clanking the first. The release, that one good. It stays down, a three-point game. So we would again expect the same type thing. And there is the foul. Luke finished out the play just in case. And don't you know, he buried the three. Well after the whistle, though. So the foul on Michael Ely will send Bumbolo to the line to shoot two. 6.2 seconds left. I still think that's enough time where you just go for both made free throws and then take your chances defending the inbound play.
That second free throw that Ely made, so big, allowed them to use the strategy of fouling to put Bumbolo at the line.
Free throw good by Luke. These are pressure-packed free throws as well for the grad student from Newcastle. Lance Irving is at the scorer's table. He's going to check in for the shooter. So if Luke makes this, Lance will probably commit a foul right away, and that free throw good. Used every bit of the rim. Actually, Lance in, and Emi Rutai-Sire out. Man-to-man defense to start here on the inbound. Duru Gordon now to Ely, right back to Duru Gordon, and the foul given right away by Bumbolo. Well, this has absolutely turned into a free throw shooting contest for the Saints. They have opted to foul Niagara to avoid the three-point play. The Purple Eagles have opted to foul because it's the last thing that they can do.
And that pass just barely made its way into its destination. It's Ely's bounce pass. Bullock had a look at it. It just got by his arm. Can Duru Gordon miss one?
Wow.
That's what the Purple Eagles are hoping.
He hasn't missed a free throw all day. This one on the way, and it is good again. 15 for 15 for Duru Gordon. Well, Siena fans, this is a different team, as I'm sure they already know, with Sean Duru Gordon on the floor. Big free throw here. Good. Again, a three-point lead by Niagara, and the foul is given right away. Niagara tried to move it before that foul came. They tried to get it to Ahmad Henderson, but the foul is on Ely, getting Bumbolo just in time. And with 3.7 seconds left, you're getting really close to where you may make the first one, miss the second one, although Niagara has Ahmad Henderson in the lowest block that they can achieve. So we'll see what they do. That free throw, no good.
Niagara made him earn it. In terms of game time with 2 minutes left, you would have never thought we'd be in this scenario, but the Purple Eagles did such a great job at creating those turnovers and forcing Siena to earn and close this one out. Still 3.7 before we get to that point, though.
Well, we'll see what the Purple Eagles do here. They did put Harlan in the game and on the low block. The Saints respond with Emma Juru. A lot of size on that left block. That free throw's on the way. Missed intentionally, and a rebound by the Saints and a foul. That one definitely was missed intentionally there by Luke. The foul will go on Harlan Obioha. For Harlan, that is his fourth. So here it is with 2.1 seconds left. A chance for Killian Gribben to put this one away for the Saints.
Just needs one of two to accomplish that goal.
He has made his two free throws here in this ball game. They're in the second half. Doesn't get there a lot. That one on the way is good, and the Saints are going to win this one. They lead it 92-88.
That's 30 points higher than they've been averaging all season long for the Saints.
And doing a job from the charity stripe, another one good. 81% from the line. A late Bumble 03 is no good, and the Saints win it. And full marks to Siena coming here into the Gallagher Center with the weight of an 8-game losing streak as we get to our combined insurance post-game show for the best in supplemental health insurance. Call Mark Callen, 716-361-9166. But credit to the Saints. They came in, they scored a ton of points way beyond their average, and they win it by five.
And they were perfect from the line. 31 points from the free throw line in this game. It's just astounding figure. Drew Gordon had 16 of those 31.
Yep, in the least surprising comment we're going to give you of the day, Sean Drew Gordon is our Firth Jewelers Player of the Game. Career high 36. He didn't do it in volume shooting. You see the 14 field goal attempts. He goes a perfect 14 for 14 from the charity stripe, and he certainly has earned the honor as the Firth Jewelers Player of the Game. Go forth to Firth.
Yeah, he's going to be a handful for anyone in the MAC. As Siena gets their playmaker and scorer, all of a sudden they're in the discussion for the top of the conference.
What a game here as the Purple Eagles, to their credit, they didn't go away without a fight. They forced late turnovers. They got it to within a one-possession game on the shoulders of Ahmad Henderson and Quan Marble. I thought Quan was sensational. Final comments, Frank.
Again, like you said, the Purple Eagles, they dug in. They're going to be there till the end. They wrap up this weekend series with a 1-1 record.
Happy to have you along here on ESPN. All games are airing and are archived on the ESPN app. Have a great afternoon, everyone. Okay, I'm like 30. Frank, final comment, 10. All right, thanks. All right, I'm off to the stadium. Yes. Later. Back to Bumble. 13 to shoot. Luke goes to his right. A three on the way. Good. A little wiggle. Duru Gordon has it now. Knocked away by Bayless. Bayless will go. Obioha with it. Back to Bumble. This Obioha and Obang Mensa. Baseline pass. Bullock reverse layup. This Obioha and Obang Mensa. Baseline pass. Bullock reverse layup. Spins through. Great ball. And they're again beginning to get more and more familiar with Duru Gordon on the floor. Obioha with it now, whips it into the corner. Bullock pulls the trigger, a three, and that is good for Niagara. Whip it across the floor. Tucker with the catch, takes it along the Bailey. Ahmad Henderson with 65 seconds left in the first half. Pull-up jumper, swish. Bailey. Bumble for the Purple Eagles, keeping that dribble alive. Seven. Bailey. Bumble for the Purple Eagles, keeping that dribble alive. 7 seconds left across the floor. Ahmad Henderson fakes a three, steps down low, layup on the way. Good, he's able to finish in traffic, and that will bring it to a close of the opening half. Path to the bucket, but dribble it away. Now he'll go back towards the rim. Ball fake out the defender in the air. Path to the bucket, but dribble it away. Now he'll go back towards the rim. Ball fake out the defender in the air, and he lays it in. Kwan flips it to Ahmad, the freshman. Good move, high off the window, good. He couldn't see the... Bumble pulls up, been looking for. Bullock fakes the three, takes down low, feeds it to Obioha, and he slams it through.
Niagara gave up, but quickly led to two points.
Bullock, a three from the top, is good. Very calmly waiting for that. This free throw on the way is good. They will. Little 1-2-1-1, full court trap by the Purple Eagles. Tekken with it in the corner. Stolen by Marble. Left wing, Ahmad. He's got a three on the way. Good!
And looking to get the W on the road.
It'll be their first road win if they get it. The Siena Saints team averages six.
And looking to get the W on the road.
It'll be their first road win if they get it. This season, as I'm sure they already know.
The mid-range jumper area.
Duru Gordon, this OBO. Duru Gordon. Duru Gordon has it now.
Knocked away by Bayless. Bayless will take it. And we are. And lay it in, and we are tied at 17. And first layup, spin through. Great play initially to give a on pass. Ball on a reverse layup, spin through. On the floor. Obioha with it now, whips it into the corner. Bullock pulls the trigger, a three, and that is good. Drake. Bumble over. Win that the Saints have been looking for. Bullock fakes the three, takes down low, feeds it to Obioha, and he slams it through. What a feed from,
gave up, but
from Dre Bullock. To his right, a three on. Tucker inbound. 60 points a game. They are sitting on 84. Tucker inbound to Henderson.
to try to expose them. Mid-range jumper area.
Obioha with it. Back to Bumble. 13 to shoot. Luke goes to his right. A three on the way. Good. A little foul on Emma Juru, but the whistle never came. Juru Gordon has it now. Knocked away by Bayless. Bayless will go coast to coast and lay it in, and we are tied at 17. In a hurry into the front court. Bullock, Bumble, Bayless, Obioha, Obang Mensa. Baseline pass. Bullock, reverse layup, spins through. Oh. More and more familiar with Juru Gordon on the floor. Obioha with it now, whips it into the corner. Bullock pulls the trigger, a three, and that is good. Keeping that dribble alive. 7 seconds left, across the floor. Ahmad Henderson fakes a three, steps down low, layup on the way. Good, he's able to finish. In traffic, and that will bring it to a close of the opening half. Low walks the tightrope in the baseline, bounce pass up top, Kwan. Kwan, oh, he had a pass to the bucket, but dribbled it away. Now he'll go back towards the rim. Ball fake out the defender in the air, and he lays it in. Win that the Saints have been looking for. Bullock fakes the three, takes down low, feeds it to Obioha, and he slams it through. What a feed from Dre Bullock. 10.
And that was one of those few offensive rebounds Niagara gave up, but quickly led to 2 points.
Bullock, a three from the top, is good. Very calmly waiting. Little 1-2-1-1, full court trap by the Purple Eagles. Tekken with it in the corner. Stolen by Marble. Left wing, Ahmad, he's got a three on the way. Good! Well, they sprung the trap. 60 points a game. They are sitting on 84. Tucker, inbound to Henderson. He's got a corner three, and that is good.